In this part A, we have a logic program with three rules. The first is a fact saying that Blinky is a fish. The second, another fact saying that Tweety is a bird. And the third is a rule with variables that tells us that if X is a bird, then X also flies. Now, first we have to determine the Hildebrand universe T. And the Hildebrand universe is the set of ground terms that can be built using the constants and the function symbols that occur in the program. And in this part of the exercise, as well as in the others, there will be no function symbols. So then all we have to do to find the Hildebrand universe is to collect the constants that occur in the program. And in this case, we just have this Blinky and Tweety. So we add them here, Blinky and Tweety, and I will only write the initials so that things are clear here in the page. Now, the next step is to find the Hildebrand base. And the Hildebrand base is the set of atoms that can be constructed using the predicates that occur in the program and all ground terms of the Hildebrand universe. Then, what are the predicates that occur in the program? Well, we have fish with one argument, bird with one argument, and flies with one argument. As you see here, to identify a predicate, we usually mention its name or its symbol and its number of argument, which is also called its arity. And we have to use both, because we could have here a predicate that could be flies. Suppose we had a fact that says flies, Tweety, fast. Right? So then this predicate flies is different than this one here, right? And this would be the predicate flies with two arguments. This is just to show you why we have to give also the arity to identify a predicate. Good, let's move on. Then these are the predicates. These are the ground terms that can be constructed with the can be constructed with the constant and function symbols of the program. In this case, we have no function symbols, so these are just the constant of the program. So we can write here all the atoms that can build with these pieces. So we have fish of bird, fish of Tweety, and now with bird, we get bird of Blinky and bird of Tweety, and similarly with flies. As you see, this is pretty straightforward. And now we have to build the ground instantiation of this program P. Let's put it here. And the ground instantiation is just the union of the ground instantiation of each rule. So for the first two, it's trivial because they have no variables, they are just facts. So then the ground instantiation is just themselves without changing anything. So we have fish of Blinky here and bird of Tweety. Now the last one is the only one that is a bit interesting, because this has this variable x, and we simply have to replace this x, but all possible by all the ground terms that belong to the Hildebrand universe. So then if we replace the x by Blinky, we get this flies, Blinky, if bird, Blinky. And if we replace the x by Tweety, we get flies, Tweety, if bird, Tweety. And that's it. This is the ground program. Now, we are asked also to find the stable model of this program P. And by definition, the stable model of this program P with variables are the stable models of its ground instantiation. So we just have to find the stable models of this ground instantiation to say which are the stable models of P. So here we have fish of Blinky, bird of Tweety, and if we have bird of Tweety, we can also derive flies of Tweety, and there's nothing else that we can derive. Hence, these three atoms are the atoms that belong to the stable model, because there's no way that we can derive bird of Blinky, and therefore no way we can derive flies of Blinky. Then we finish the exercise just writing down here the stable model fish of Blinky. Oops. Bird of Tweety and flies of Tweety. And that's it. As you have seen, this was very easy. Let's move then to the next one.